In this video, I'm gonna give you the most important trading indicators that professional commodity traders use. So if you are thinking about investing time and money into commodity related assets, buckle up and listen carefully to this video because it could make you or save you a lot of money. But before diving, if you are wondering why I'm competent to speak about the subject, I'm Damien, a former commodity trader, and not like all these others, a YouTuber trader that filmed himself in front of tens of screens. I was hired and paid by companies to make money trading on commodity markets. As such, I spent 10 years trying to figure out what makes market moves. So the indicator that I'm going to reveal is by far the most powerful. Over the years, I spoke about it with the commodity traders, hedge fund managers, academic, quants, and we didn't agree on a lot of things, but on that indicator, we pretty much all agreed. Without further ado, the best trading indicator in commodity trading is the inventory level. Basically, the global inventory level tracks the amount of a specific commodity stored on the globe. And it works like that. The higher the inventory level rises, the more likely the chance of a price decrease. The lower the inventory level goes, the more likely the chance to see a price increase. I know, it sounds very simple and it is, but please listen to the end of the video because there is more. It's important to understand that holding inventories cost money for a company. They have to pay for insurance fees, storage fees, and financing fees. So at the end of the day, a company can't hold inventories forever and just wait for the price of commodity to go up again to sell it. Okay, so now that you know that inventories cost money, let's check another indicator that is based on the inventory level and the demand. The other indicator that I want to talk about is called days of supply. This is the inventory level divided by the total demand that gives you the numbers of days of supply before we run out of the commodity. This is a really good short and mid-term indicators. But on the long run, if you look at it on a 10 to 20 year basis, you will notice that the day of supply decreases slowly, and it has nothing to do with the prices. It's just that over the time, supply chains got better and users were like, okay, we can maybe have only 5 days, 10 days or 20 days of supplies in our factory because we know that we can get quite easily the commodity. Unfortunately, I can tell you more about all the research that I did with my coworkers on the day of supply. Obviously, it's because I was an employee, so I have like a contract that I need to follow, and I cannot like tell everything. Even though I think that I say a lot of things on this YouTube channel, I still know where are the limits, and this one is already on the edge. But yeah, I just can encourage you to look into the day of supplies because it's a real good indicator. It's not a bullshit indicator as all the other ones that you can see on YouTube, like, I don't know, RSI, Bollinger Band, or whatever shit of the day. So this one is solid, so do whatever you want with this information. That was all I had to say today. If you learned something, please like the video. It always helps. And also, if you are into academic papers, you may want to type on Google commodity prices and inventories, and you will find a lot of academic papers on how the storage level affect the price curve. If you are into that kind of stuff, you will love it. And yeah, ciao.